Robert Mutebi, the Commissioner for Information Technology and Innovation, during the meeting with Lira political leaders and other stakeholders, informed the gathering that in the next financial year, the citizens are required to fund 56% of the national budget.
29.7 is to be mobilized internally from taxes and non-tax revenues, and the rest will come from aid and grants. So the two things I want to underline, 52.7 is the total budget.
To popularize, promote access to information on the budget and obtain feedback from the citizens.
He said the task is to raise the GDP ratio from the current 13.5% to 14.6% in the current financial year.
For example, now you are going to impose tax on building materials. And you should note that most of our people, 90%, live in squalid conditions. The houses are not good. We are lacking more than 5 million homes that we need to build.
There are a lot of gaps, there are a lot of monies that have gone to waste in corruption. And yet at the end of the day, we are coming back to you. You are a waste money.
Patrick Paul Mwanja, the Commissioner for Finance and Planning, said the aim of the engagement was to increase public ownership of the national budget and equip Ugandans with knowledge and information on the budget so they can monitor execution.
By increasing the involvement and awareness of budget activities and initiatives. Secondly, is to equip Ugandans with knowledge and information on the budget so as to facilitate them to effectively monitor budget execution at all levels of government.
Persons with disability have a lot of challenges. When we talked about the revenue or taxations, there are no clear guidelines that can support persons with disability in terms of maybe subsidizing the taxation. We are also paying tax like any other able bodies.
Report by Hudson Apunyo for the news.